Jokic, once he saw that he was looking to pass, he tried to pressure him a little bit, but that right there, that's where the foul is. I didn't really see anything from the ankle.
Right on the mark.
When AD dropped down holding that Achilles.
Oh my gosh, I thought it was another KD situation.
I had to pause. I was just thinking to myself, why the fuck did AD have to play this game? Like, bro, my heart stopped. In a lot of the games, we haven't been trying. So I wouldn't say they haven't been entertaining, but they're dominant right now. You know what I'm saying? But when this happened, I came back to reality. I start remembering the seasons when we wasn't dominant every game. The Robert Saker years. I'm like, bro, we really gotta play some basketball now because Anthony Davis almost tore his Achilles. I almost had a heart attack. The Anthony Davis injury, like everybody said, it was an Achilles injury, but he didn't tear his Achilles tendons, but he did have some swelling, but it wasn't on the tendon. So that's good news. A lot of people have been complaining about AD this season, how he has been ass. He been trashed a little bit, you know what I'm saying, on both ends of the floor. He doesn't really have that menace of a defensive attitude that he used to have last season, and he's not really dominating on the offensive end. I'm seeing AD shoot post fadeaways over 6'4 guards. It's frustrating. AD had a short offseason. He's been banged up in the playoffs multiple times, and he also has an Achilles injury that's not to be taken lightly, because an Achilles injury is the worst injury in sports. We need to get off AD back. I think AD wants to play some games because it's not like AD should be low managing. He's only 27. He's in his prime of his career. But right now, bro, I don't want to see AD until probably mid-March or late March. I don't care about no regular season records. That's the thing about Laker fans. We take every game so serious that we need to just sit back and look at our record. We're 20-6. It does not matter, bro. If we top three, top two in the West, that's good. We don't have to win 60, 65 games. We're good, bro. We don't have to go hard. And AD probably made the Lakers go hard. Especially for LeBron James. LeBron James is 36 years of age, year 18. He's been playing great, better than what you expect anybody 18 years in the game to ever do. I don't want LeBron to do more than what he's already doing. He's playing a career low in minutes, trolling the whole game. If you watch the games, LeBron James is basically doing whatever he wants on the floor, good or bad, for the first three quarters. And then 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter, he turns into LeBron James that won us the championship last year. But I don't have a problem with that because they still win him. Now fucking LeBron got to play 42 minutes just to keep the Lakers afloat. Ah, dang, bro. Now LeBron might break some records in that span. But I want LeBron James to chill out for the playoffs. Laker fans, the big goal is the playoffs. Win in the playoffs. Regular season awards do not matter for us, bro. Come on, bro. We not about no regular season against no Brooklyn Nets, against no Clippers. We want that big ring. Good thing about AD's injury, well, it's not a good thing, but we get to have Kyle Kuzma starter minutes. Now, if you know Kyle Kuzma, he's a whole different player from being a starter to being a bench player. As a bench player, he's a good rebounder, a glue guy. He likes to hustle, play defense, and basically that's it. Starter Kuz turns to the reincarnation of Tracy McGrady. He scores, he shoots, he's aggressive. He does everything on that end. He was year one and year two Kyle Kuzma. So this can help for Kyle Kuzma's confidence as a player. Basically everybody confidence as players, especially the young players. Talon Horton-Tucker is going to get more time. Morris is going to get more time. Wesley Matthews. Basically everybody, because AD covered a lot of holes that the Lakers have. So we expect these players to fill in those holes very great. It's hard to replace a guy that can get you 30 points a game with all NBA defense. But Laker fans, do not panic. We is good. We just have to weather the storm. LeBron James is probably going to see an uptick in minutes, points, shot attempts, turnovers, it's every single thing. Talon Horton-Tucker to reassert himself as a great player, as he already is. Alex Caruso to bring some of that defensive intensity back like he usually has. Kuzma just to be like regular year two Kuzma, and we'll be straight.
And Marc Gasol, bro, please fight for your life, bro. You was too old to be playing more minutes than you already is. Everybody got to step up. Frank Vogel has to reorganize the whole rotation of Lakers so we can stay afloat. And even if AD comes back, he might not be 100%. He might be 65, 75%, which is a good player. 75% of Anthony Davis is a good player, but we want him healthy, bro. I'm tired of seeing Anthony Davis fall down, and then I'm grabbing for my heart because I'm nervous. Let this man rest, bro. Put this man in a gazillion ice baths a day. Let him get an MRI. It's coming Monday. And yeah, man, we'll be all right. This is probably a short video, but bro, make sure you like and subscribe. I am trying to do a video every day, bro. I had to do the tweak in my work schedule, like my regular job and everything else I'm doing. So the uploads have been kind of slow, but I'm getting more comfortable at doing daily videos even after work, even though I am tired as hell. But it doesn't matter. So for that, bro, make sure you hit the like button, bro. Do me a favor in that and subscribe if you watch my videos and never subscribe. You are op if you don't subscribe. But that'd be all, man. Make sure y'all have a safe February, a great Black History Month, and I'm out, man. Peace.